this video, we'll be showing you how to adjust the trip points and delay settings on the MicroLogic 5.0 and 6.0 A, P, and H trip units by using the dial settings. In this video, we are using a MicroLogic 6.0 H trip unit, but the same process will apply on all the previously mentioned trip units. Also, the trip unit that we are using in this video is installed in a MasterPack NW breaker. However, they can be installed in the PowerPack P and R frames, as well as the MasterPack NT and NW breakers. Before operating on the trip unit, make sure to consult all the safety information provided with the breaker and never work on energized equipment. First, you will need to open the trip unit door. On the MicroLogic P and H trip units, this door is opaque, and on the MicroLogic A trip units, it will be a clear door. There is a small tab at the top of the door that you can fit a flathead screwdriver in and then pop the door open to reveal all of the dials that are available to you on your trip unit. The dials that are available on the MicroLogic 5.0 trip units will be the IR dial, which is the long time trip point. The settings that are on here are multipliers of the sensor rating of the breaker. You will also have the TR dial, which is the long time delay setting. All of the settings that are on this dial are given in seconds. You will also have the ISD dial, which is the short time trip point. These are multipliers of the IR long time trip setting. You will also have the TSD dial, which is the short time delay setting. The settings on this are given in seconds as well, and you will notice that there are two sides to it, the non-shaded on side and the shaded off side. These are for the purpose of zone selective interlocking, and if you are using zone selective interlocking, you would use the shaded off side. And if you are not using zone selective interlocking, you would use the non-shaded on side. And you will also have the II dial, which is the instantaneous trip point. These are again multipliers of the sensor rating of the breaker. Now on MicroLogic 6.0 trip units, you will have two additional dials for ground fault. You'll have the IG, which is the ground fault trip point, and you'll have the TG, which is the ground fault delay setting. The ground fault trip point dial has letters instead of any kind of multiplier. You will need to refer to the instruction manual provided with the trip unit for the actual amperage of what each letter corresponds to. For the ground fault delay, it is similar to the TSD short time delay setting in that it is in seconds and it has a non-shaded on side and a shaded off side. Again, you will use the shaded off side when using zone selective interlocking and the non-shaded on side when not using zone selective interlocking. To change the dial setting, you will use a small flathead screwdriver, insert it in the dial, and turn the dial to the desired setting. You will see on the screen, if it is powered up, that when you do this, it will show the setting that is being changed and show the actual value that it has been changed to. Once you have all of your desired dial settings set as you need them, there is no additional step in order to save the settings. The dial settings that are set are already saved within the trip unit. So once you are done, you can then close the trip unit door and the trip unit is ready to operate.